Yeah, there was.
I gotta go see Alice.
See Alice, you gotta go see Alice.
I gotta go see Alice. Lo Vitra, come here, girl.
Come on, Vi.
Bye. Viagra Falls.
Viagra Falls.
Slowly, I turn.
If you just tuned in, first of all, I want to say I'm sorry. And secondly, yes. this is the Sir Walter Jones Show. And what we do, we talk about just issues and things going on in a Christian's life. You know, Christians have the same problems that non-Christians have.
I once saw a bumper sticker that says, Christians are no different than anyone else. We're just forgiven.
Oh, wow. I like that.
I love it, too.
Well, that's good to say. Now, when Jesus was on the earth, did he spend a whole lot of time in church?
No.
He didn't?
He did go to the tabernacle, but he spent more time with the people in the day-to-day lives.
I see.
Teaching the parables and helping them understand their purpose in a relationship to God versus the temple.
I see. Yeah. So, but he talked with regular people.
Oh, yeah.
Prostitutes.
He didn't like the Pharisees.
No, he didn't.
Because they weren't fair.
You see. And he didn't talk to the Sadducees either.
They were depressed. They're sad, you see.
Yeah. And that's true. Yeah. But there was a history, as we get back to the whole women's situation, about when they were allowed to do certain things. They were treated like
second class
citizens, sure. And they were not allowed to do a lot of things until there was a need or there was a hole and they had to fill it.
Help meet.
Yes. right. Is that M-E-E-T or M-E-A-T?
Either way.
All right. Yes, it is. Hallelujah.
Depends on your flavor.
All right there. So remember when we went off to war in World War II? World War I and II, but especially World War II.
Yes, they had to step up.
They had to step up. Now, where did they step up, though?
They stepped up in every area of culture.
Okay.
They went to the factories to help in the textile industry. They helped build the guns. They helped build the ammunition. Mm-hmm. They stepped up academically. There was a huge influx of teachers because the male teachers had gone off to war, too.
Sure.
They stepped up even in athletics. You had the women baseball league that even began because all the baseball players were going to war.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, so, yeah, they stepped up. And I thank God for a woman stepping up.
Yeah, me too. I am too. They have a lady called the Rosie the Riveter. And Dion, if you can go on YouTube and find that, there's a song called Rosie the Riveter song. Okay, I want that played right at this break. Rosie the Riveter, and it's an old song. Yeah, you'll know it's an old because it sounds like it's from the 1930s.
I wonder what that sound like.
Rosie was a woman that they call. You know, now you know what a riveter is, right?
A riveter.
Yeah.
A person that rivets.
Yeah, that's basically what it is.
And well, what's a rivet?
A rivet is the...
Making farts? I mean, frog sounds?
No,
rivet.
No.
Rivet.
No, not rivet. No, oh. No. No, rivet, it's like a, you know, the you got that machine that drills, not drills, but it, it's like an electric...
like a power screwdriver or drill.
There you go.
Okay.
Right. And it's got a rivet on the end that you know, the skyscrapers.
That binds the thing together.
Yeah, there you go.
All right, so they professional screwers.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Alvin. They were professional riveters. And so,
come on, baby, let's rivet.
Yep, this is UBM talk for sure.
I'm taking advantage of that.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. And so they that's what they coined the name. Rosie the Riveter.
Rosie the Riveter.
Yeah. Okay. Now, there's something happened, though, because a lot of those women, they had to take on the jobs that the men had.
Yes, and then they had to give them up.
After the war.
Yes.
They had to give them up. Now, but that caused something else as well. Giving them up. Now, they gave them up, which means made them home now, makers.
Yes.
Because the men who came from war, now they needed to work.
Right.
So they gave them up. But a lot of the riveting... Some of the riveting continues, a lot of it stopped because the purpose of the riveting was to make war planes and
planes, boats, tanks, and machines.
Yeah,
war machines.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Right, absolutely. So the war was over, so they didn't really need to do that. Okay, and so a lot of them went back home, and some of them stayed in the workplace.
Okay.
Which opened up the door to some pros and cons.
Yeah.
Because I think the wonderful thing about that is that it allowed women now to be professionals.
Other than just maids.
Uh-huh. Absolutely.
And
yeah,
the home caregivers. And
yes. Yes. And all that stuff.
But yeah, because, you know, women went to college, but they had a degree, but could do nothing with it.
Mm-hmm. That's true. That's true. And it's funny you say that. Here's the thing about women at work. In colonial America, women who earned their own living usually became seamstresses or kept boarding houses. But some women worked in the professions and jobs available mostly to men. There were women doctors.
Okay.
Lawyers, preachers, teachers, writers, and singers. By the early 19th century, however, acceptable occupations for working women were limited to factory labor or domestic work. Women were excluded from the professions except for writing and teaching after the war ended.
Okay.
Okay. But then what it did was the men who were looking for jobs, some of these women stayed on those jobs. So that didn't allow the man to work. So, and if he was trying to take care of his family, there was a woman there. And that seemed like it caused some problems in America. And I think maybe if you're male chauvinist, especially.
Definitely.
That will cause problems. Because like, well, I can't work because that woman over there is working.
She got my job.
She got my job. Yeah, yeah. And I think some of that has changed into.
You know, she wasn't giving up that money.
No, absolutely not. What we're going to do, we need to go to a break right quick. I hope you got that tune. Okay, yeah, we're going to play Rosie the Riveter. And we got a young lady who's going to join us in 1 second. And we'll get back and then we'll drop that phone number to you, okay? This is the Walter Jones Show.
Hello, this is Leon Finney, your host of Another Perspective on UrbanBroadcastMedia.com. We are the voice of Black America. Join me and my guests every Saturday from 4 to 5 p.m. as we discuss the issues that impact Black America. Tune in to UBM Talk on UrbanBroadcastMedia.com, the simulcast on our affiliate station WBON 1690 AM. That's Another Perspective every Saturday from 4 to 5 p.m. And you can run and tell that.
Hi, I'm Neil Harper.
And I'm Takora Rogers.
Listen each Wednesday from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. for Ubuntu, Humanity Towards Others, right here on UBM Talk Radio. It's a radio show that deals with everything in the African-American community, from Miami to Moscow. We'll deal with your issues, so give us a call and let us know what those are. That's Ubuntu, Humanity Towards Others, right here every Wednesday from 1 to 2 p.m. on UBM Talk Radio.
A Vibrant Mix is back with a new format.
Same informative and vibrant topics.
And a new co-host.
Yep, we heard you. And Cousin Fred is on permanently.
Hey, this is Fred. Join us every Friday from noon until 1. Same great conversation, same Vibrant Mix.
A Vibrant Mix with Tasha and Tamiko.
And Fred.
Right here on UrbanBroadcastMedia.com.
Lord, how did I get in between TNT?
Watch out, Fred. We're explosive.
A part of the assembly line. She's making history, working for victory. Rosie. the riveter keeps a sharp lookout for sabotage. Sitting up there on the fuselage, that little frail can do more than a male can do. Rosie, the riveter, Rosie's got a boyfriend, Charlie. Charlie, he's a Marine. Rosie is protecting Charlie, working overtime on the riveting machine. When they gave her a production knee, she was as proud as a girl could be. There's something true about red, white, and blue about Rosie, the riveter.
This is the Sir Walter Jones Show. It's Sir Walter Jones, and I'm so glad you're here. We moved out of the basement into the upper room.
The upper room.
We are up here.
Where Jesus.
And I like what they did to the place.
It smelled better.
Yeah, and after this show, they probably had to put us back down there. Thanks, Alvin.
Oh.
We have in the room here a female, thank God.
Yeah, estrogen.
Because all this testosterone was giving me a headache.
She got a heavy voice.
Melanie is here. Melanie, what's the name of your show?
Melodies from Heaven. Mellow P.
Oh, Melody. Ooh, that sounds kind of nice.
Mellow P.
Mellow P, yeah.
That was a strong P.
Yeah. Yep. I know.
I'm not even going.
Don't even go there. How you doing, girl?
I'm well. How are you
doing? I'm wonderful. I'm glad you're here.
Thank you so much for inviting me.
I saw her at...
Don't tell.
I have to tell it.
Because we was both being great.
We were. You know how you all, you can't go into a strip joint and say, I can't believe I saw John up
you
there.
You will never believe who I saw.
You will never believe. Yeah. So I saw her at Baskin Robbins.
Ooh, the devil.
Yeah. And I hit her on the shoulder. I said, you that famous lady from UBM Praise? She like, yes, it's me. And she turned around and saw who I was. She said, oh, fool, go sit down.
I didn't say that.
I have discernment. You said it in your spirit. Yep, and I asked her to come on, and here she is, and I want to thank you so much for coming on.
And I thank you for the invitation.
Today is Women's Perspectives. It's we talk about issues, both issues, his shoes and her shoes. And yesterday, and what we do, we try to piggyback off of yesterday's conversation, okay? Mm-hmm. Yesterday's conversation was,
why won't he marry me?
That's it. Yeah. Why won't he marry me? Okay. First question to you. Are you married?
No, I'm not.
Okay. That means we know. I know what we.